So why is Pepe Coin dumping? What exactly is happening here? After we've seen this pump here on the weekend, as we expected before in previous videos, we've seen a quick dump here and Pepe Coin failed at going to retest this trend line here as we were expecting in the previous videos. But nonetheless, we had some nice profits here on this pump here, but unfortunately Pepe Coin couldn't find the strength to keep going on this uptrend here and we failed to push forward. So what exactly is happening? This is what we're going to see in this video here. We go towards this high here and going toward 28k 500. So exactly as predicted in the previous video, BTC went towards this level here and got rejected. This was an expected rejection and unfortunately we were expecting PepeCoin to follow trend, to follow BTC, but PepeCoin couldn't follow. We had a quick pump here and then dump right after BTC found weakness. So this tells us that the whole crypto market now is feeling a bit anxious. The crypto market now is at a maximum alert. As soon as BTC gets rejected, the whole crypto space or altcoins dump. As we can see here on the Bitcoin dominance is slowly grinding its way up here locally. If we look at on the weekly, the Bitcoin dominance is looking about to break above here, and if this happens, this means that the altcoin season will have to hold for a while BTC leads this rally before we see any pumps or any major pumps here on PepeCoin. Now to explain to you as well the price action that we see here on PepeCoin, as I see many people are speculating right now that there is a lot of sell pressure on PepeCoin, that whales are selling. Usually people do not understand that PepeCoin here or the whole crypto space is mainly, the price action is mainly driven by derivative traders, by future trading, and mainly the spot is being inactive. As if we look at the wallet addresses that hold PepeCoin here, not much has changed, and so far Binance wallet holds almost 20% of the total supply of PepeCoin here, which is bullish. So we should all know that Binance never loses. We should all know that Binance never loses. The house never loses. The house always wins. If Binance is holding 20% of the supply here, they probably wait. They won't dump any of that PepeCoin until PepeCoin sees a rise, and probably they are waiting for the next bull market to do so. Now the whole thing here that is happening with PepeCoin is mainly future trading, derivatives, shorts vs longs, and this is the whole theater we are seeing here. It's basically that, no whale selling or anything like that. As for this pump here, this pump here mainly got triggered because we had a lot of shorts piling up on the way down. Everyone was expecting lower, and this usually is called a short squeeze. We had a pump, and if we remember from the previous video, I was expecting the same to happen here. As the price starting to rally upward, we were expecting the funding rate here on PepeCoin to turn negative, meaning that a lot of shorts have entered the market and this would fuel the pump up, and so far we are not seeing this happen right now. And I'm waiting personally for PepeCoin here to see any major funding rate. So far shorts here are not interested, neither are longs. That's why the price is kind of stagnating like that. This is a real huge sign of low liquidity, and nobody is trading right now PepeCoin, neither are people buying nor selling PepeCoin here. So the price would kind of fluctuate like that for a while. What would be a major buying opportunity for PepeCoin? As I've been saying, any major lows here would be very, very bullish for PepeCoin here to get to these lows here while the funding rates gets negative. Now the whole space is centered toward BTC here and what is going to happen. Now any break above this resistance, this downtrend on BTC would be bullish for the whole crypto space, and as well for PepeCoin. We could see major pumps. And now so far we want these lows here to hold strong to keep our bullish structure intact, as we also have bullish news now coming in for the whole economy, as the US debt ceiling now is suspended until 2025, which is a very interesting date. Probably this year is gonna be huge for the whole market, as also China is building a lot of infrastructure for cryptocurrency and the Web3, and they are expecting to reach full capacity by 2025, as well as the debt ceiling suspended until 2025. Does this mean that we are now at the start of a bull market and this will start from here until 2025? I still do believe that we could get a little pullback here on BTC, and this would be the last one before a major rally going through the whole year of 2024 and going towards 2025. As for PepeCoin, for the long term, this is a normal ranging here, as we've seen in many other coins that just get listed on major exchanges like Binance. Like they do a top like that, then we say major ranging and then a pump following a bull market. We still have Binance holding 20% of the supply, still bullish long term for on PepeCoin. Now don't forget to subscribe, like the video. I publish daily. I keep you guys updated about the whole crypto space, about what's going on, where we at. I hope this video was helpful. I'll see you on the next one. Cheers. We'll be right back.